Hello folks, now today we are going to discuss about globalization. So the first thing is that this world has become a global village nowadays. Like the change in the world order brought about by various social, cultural, technology, economic as well as political development in the 20th century have led to a growing interdependence between societies and communities in an unprecedented way. Now, this has led to the reworking of a relation between peoples and institutions in a manner that has come to impinge upon contemporary lifestyle and human conduct. Like, it's a type of interchanging. The phenomena of globalization involves the propagation and promotion of a culture of interactivity where people from different locations and situations are engaged in various activities. That means it is correlated. Suppose if I have a culture of India, so I can transfer that culture to other country and accept their culture. Now, this is a interconnection or interactivity. Like, in other words, globalization has led to a remapping of priorities and structure. One of the primary aspects of globalization has been the growth of capitalism. The primary thing is we are talking about capitalism as the major economic structure determining relations among people in various parts of the world. Now, financial control and enhanced means of communication, especially in a technological driven age, has rendered the conventional labor capital equation redundant, which is leading to a growing deregulation of traditional economic structure. In terms of the economic aspects, you see, globalization circumvents the authority of the state by constructing alternative power centers and often determines the direction of politics. Now, if you talk about the state, you can say that, well, the state has not disappeared because of globalization. It has warranted a reorientation of traditional state-society relations. Now, there are some dangers of globalization. Like you can say, the dangers of globalization are recognized even as its benefits are received by people in various parts of the world. So both things we have the merit as well as demerit of globalization. Now we'll little discuss about the demerit of globalization. The first thing we'll be talking about pluralization. Now, could work as a sustainable system if the world were populated by rather dim economic men and women. But it is not. It is full of human beings with hopes and dreams and expectations. Everybody has got to do something. They have got their own dreams. They have their own expectations. Now, this will not be accommodated across the world to prevent a politics of polarization destroying all. An interconnected world is an easily, sabotaged world. Like if you talk about the terrorism nowadays, the politics of the weak has followed an upward trend. Now, this terrorism is only due to globalization. Another thing, although the threat of globalization is now being recognized in some quarters, it has been a very fashionable phenomena. It has been a very fashionable phenomena nowadays in the age where technology and interconnectivity are taken as inevitable givens. That means due to technology, loss of terrorism are increasing day by day. Another thing we're going to talk about is that globalization refers to a multidimensional set of social interdependencies and exchanges, while at the same time fostering in people a growing awareness of deepening connections between the local and the distance. Suppose I don't have something which I wanted nowadays. Now you see the online business which they are doing nowadays. You can get everything from your house. Even you are in a remote area, even you can achieve that particular goods which you want. So the world has become totally interconnected. Another thing I'm going to talk about is that Globalization also involves the importance of the internationalisms of lifestyle. Now our lifestyle has totally changed. Suppose you want a t-shirt which a European has got and you don't have with you. So within a few days you can get that. That means the lifestyle of the people, even of the in the remote areas, has also been changed. Now the idea of the personal is affected by the condition of social and cultural changes that literally are quite removed from individual's experience. So even your lifestyle, even your culture is also being changed due to globalization. Now, various institutional agencies, some of them are often called multinational. We all know we are talking about the multinational company, which is well connected. Lots of countries are connected with one country, and we like export and import business through this connectivity. We do this. It operates in different parts of the world today, and the complex modes of production that characterize the operation of the markets demonstrate that the condition of life in many places of the world have moved beyond the immediate concerns of particular territories. That means due to globalization, the lifestyle of the people has been totally changed. Another thing we are talking about, like the negation of distance in many aspects of contemporary life, is one of the features of globalization. While the disadvantage, we are also talking about the disadvantage of globalization are being recognized. Like you can say, like trafficking in illicit drugs, like a quick transfer of diseases which you are having now at the present moment you are suffering from. That means from coronavirus, the whole world has been locked down. So this is the reason of that globalization, only due to globalization that we are having, that people are coming from different countries, going to different countries, like immigrations and terrorism are some of the hazards of a network existence. So these are the problem of globalization, or you can say the demerits of globalization. Another thing, the most evident and recognizable positive aspects of globalization has been the transfer of technology. Now, technology has developed a lot during this era for a better and more secure life. That means people are very much secure due to technology. Globalization has led to increased sharing of various kinds of resources among peoples, technology, economic, like information and culture modes and customs. Like we get each and everything with this globalization. That means the people, the technologically, economically, culturally, people are developing nowadays. Now there are notable conditions behind the way globalization has come to impact contemporary life. I'll give us two examples. That one of the role played by such global institution as the World Bank. You see the World Bank, the International Monetary Fund of the United States. So, or the United States, which are having a lot of giving helping hand to the people of different countries. Now, another thing we're talking about, the speed. Now, what do you mean by speed here in globalization? Now, speed is a keyword in today's globalized life. Everything moves faster than it has ever done before. Like things and technologies update very quickly. Life itself moves as a fast pace. Like social relationship, including family life, are one of its calamities in many urban centers of the world. Let me see, the equally rapid movement of disease, I was talking about the coronavirus, and also you can talk about the other disease like AIDS, which is spreading very much in this world, is a major cause of concern. Now, another thing, if you talk about the cultural activities, now in the cultural sphere, globalization has changed the way media circulates in contemporary life. Like the publication industry is now one of the major movers of the world economy. The bestsellers are globally consumed products. Writers have been managed to make a name for themselves through both aggressive marketing and quality have benefited from a global market. Now, globalization, we know, is thus a postmodern development, and it is increasing day by day. People are being very much helpful to it. That means we can say that the whole world has now have become a global village, but we can also find different type of merits and also demerits. So these are the things, the more important factors of the postmodern development, that is globalization. So students, I think you have understood me clearly. I said in a very short way so that you can understand properly. So if you have any question regarding this, you can ask me. Thank you. Stay happy, stay fine, stay at home.